A celestial greenery, basking in the warmth of a bright sunshine. That's how thousands of tourists have described the southern state of Kerala. The sunshine that enriches the beauty of Kerala's verdant landscape is also helping to fulfill its energy needs through solar power. As the first fully electrified state in the country, Kerala's tries with the sunshine manifest in several projects that generate electricity in places as diverse as airports, canals and dams. With Anert, the Agency for Non-Conventional Energy and Rural Technology, taking a lead role in turning the sunshine to energy, Kerala's solar future is certainly brighter than ever before. This is the Cochin International Airport at Nedumbashery, which has also gained fame as the first airport in the world fully powered by solar energy. The Kochi Green Powered Airport produces 1 lakh units of electricity every day, whereas the average daily consumption of the airport is 95,000 units a day. The Cochin International Airport Limited, CIAL, has a total solar power installed capacity of 25 megawatts as of now, and measures are taken to scale it up to 40 megawatts by March 2018. The solar panels spread over nearly 25 hectares of land. Commissioned in October 2015, this green project produces power that is equivalent to energy we get from burning 7 lakh metric tons of coal over a period of 25 years. Kerala has been using solar energy in the transport sector too. The reason is that of the Solar Board, introduced as a pilot project of the State Water Transport Department. This solar-powered boat service operating from Vaikkam to Thavanakadavu in Ernakulam district can carry 75 persons and can travel at a speed of 5.5 to 7.5 nautical miles per hour. This boat is powered by the solar modules with a capacity of 19.5 kilowatt fixed on its roof and two 20 kilowatt-hour battery banks that store the power. Canals and reservoirs of the hydroelectric projects of Kerala State Electricity Board Limited have been successfully used to install floating and canal top power plants. The vast expanse of water at the Banasura Sagar Reservoir in Wayanad was once a favorite boating destination for tourists. Today, it also offers the unique site of the largest floating solar project in the country. This project has been implemented at a cost of Rs 9.2 crore on an area of 1.2 acres. This floating solar plant would generate 6.5 lakh units of electricity annually. Banasura Sagar Dam has also a unique dam-top solar plant. The 3-megawatt Barapol small hydel project in Kannur district, which initially caught popular attention through its use of the trenchware, is now gaining popularity for its implementation of the canal-top solar power plant. However, the greatest help rendered by solar power to Kerala in recent times was in achieving total electrification of the state. The state resorted to the use of solar power for ensuring last-mile connectivity in remote and isolated tribal villages which could not be linked through electricity distribution lines. Over 2,000 houses, located mostly inside the dense forest in Idukki, Palakkad and Wayanad districts, have been electrified using solar power provided by Anert. With solar energy being established as the most popular green energy, Kerala is devoting a great deal of attention to popularizing the use of solar power. In addition, Kerala is concentrating on hybrid power also by linking more than one renewable energy source. One such instance is the wind solar hybrid power plant at Ramakalmedu in Idukki district, for which Agency for Non-Conventional Energy and Rural Technology, ANERT, has already initiated steps. The project is implemented with the support of indigenously developed technology of the Center for Development of Advanced Computing, CDAC. In addition to these projects, Kerala has also been promoting the installation of rooftop solar power plants for encouraging the use of green energy and for taking pride in it. One instance is the prestigious mission carried out by ANERT to convert every rooftop in Kerala into a solar power plant. The rooftop solar power plants come as a solution to the major hurdle posed by the non-availability of land for implementing large-scale power projects. Anert has also set up a solar project of 2 megawatt at Kuralmandam in Palakkad district. The 50-megawatt solar park in the Kasaragod district is also a major achievement in the green energy sector of Kerala. The Paika small hydroelectric projects of the Energy Management Center also merits mention as a less polluting generation attempt. All these initiatives point to the vision of the government in encouraging the spread of green energy in the state. This vision will certainly enable Kerala to attain self-sufficiency in energy needs through green energy. Above all, we would see the rise of Kerala as a land beautified not just by its celestial greenery, but also by a culture of green energy.